All right, bull bid right in here for ESU. Fourth down on the Georgia Tech 18. Four ticks left. Kane sets him down.
Coach, this is the second year in a row you failed to go to a bowl game. Do you feel your program's in decline?
I think we have a young team on the verge. We'll be going to a major bowl next year.
That was nice.
Hey, Joe. Good throw. What's there?
Another year home for Christmas.
Next year. Next year we sell out. Next year we dominate.
You still need a deep threat or a breakaway back to go with Joe Kane. So what are you going to do to address this need?
Well, stop wasting my time talking to you guys for one thing.
Coach, you need to
I'm not going to lead you into the fog here, Sam. I'm concerned about our program. It's always been a source of pride to our students and alumni. Two so-so seasons is having a damaging effect on our fundraising, both public and private.
So let me get this straight. What you're trying to say here, Grant, is that after 12 years, my job's in jeopardy.
I'm not prepared to discuss your job right now. I just want you to be aware of the situation. The alumni and the legislature are unhappy, and they vote with their checkbooks. I don't pretend to be an expert on football, Sam, but I do know we need to win next year.
Tickets are in your bag. Itinerary and player profiles are in your briefcase. You got a 9 o'clock tomorrow morning in Philly with this kid, Darnell Jefferson.
Damn. Looks like I lost some weight.
This kid could be the game breaker we're looking for. He had a 108-yard kickoff return against Taft. Michigan's been down to see him twice.
What was the name of that high school again?
Taft.
Darnell. You have the potential to start for us as a freshman. That 108-yard kickoff return you made against Taft, that was probably one of the greatest runs I've ever seen a high school player make. Now, Michigan, they're set a tailback for 2 years. But with us, and Joe here getting the ball in our thunder right, hell, excuse me, Reverend, you could be an All-American by your sophomore year.
Yes, but I'm more concerned with Darnell's education. He came here late. He's got some catching up to do.
Well, education is the first priority in our program. That's why all my players are smarter than me.
Merry Christmas, Mama.
Very pretty, Alvin.
When I turn pro, I'm gonna get you the house to go with it.
Running low on brew. Didn't expect you home this year, Joe. Won't be here next year.
Yeah, well, we won't rent your place on the couch.
Merry Christmas, Dad.
Yeah, Merry fucking Christmas.
Darnell, ESU, we just wanna welcome you.
good to see you again. Welcome to SU.
Glad to be here, man.
I got somebody I'd like you to meet. This is Autumn Haley, and she'll be showing you around.
Hi, Darnell.
How you doing?
It's nice to meet you.
Pleasure's all mine.
This is it. Wolf Den Stadium.
Damn.
Now for the starting lineup for the ESU Timberwolves. At tailback, number 20, Darnell Jefferson.
They got their right. Yo, thanks for showing me around the campus. I don't get the chance to meet too many girls like you, you know? You got a lot of class. Real efficacious.
Thank you.
You're welcome. Hope I can see you in the fall.
Me too.
ESU's where I'm going. I'll be number 20, but we're indubitably gonna be number one. What's up, man?
Good to see you.
All right.
This is Bud Light Kaminsky, Darnell Jefferson.
Nice to meet you.
Good. Nice to meet you.
Let's
right.
Head out.
Hey, I got a question for you, man.
Yeah, what's that?
What happened to the band and the dancing honeys and all that good shit y'all used to make me come here?
Oh, yeah, well, regular students don't come back for another 2 weeks, so, not that they would be here anyway. See, we got you now, so,
Just another worm shit freshman, man.
So, I see how it's going.
Welcome to college.
Goddamn, the lead dog is back.
How's it going?
There goes Bobby. My cover of the media, guys.
This is Darnell Jefferson, Bobby.
What's up?
Hey, Josie, can I get a couple of tequilas? Thanks.
Hey, Joe, you know, I was hoping that you might have rolled your bike or something this summer. You know, nothing serious. Just enough to keep you out for the season.
Well, no such luck, backup man. But perhaps I can engineer a few blowouts, give you a little mop-up time.
Much obliged, Joe.
My God, lads, you put on some weight, huh?
Gained about 35 pounds. Tired of watching you guys play, so I spent my summer in the gym. I intend to start this year.
You get any bigger, you can play offense.
Yeah, but don't I have to get dumber than do?
Is that really possible?
No!
Here's to a new season.
Come on.
Hey, you still seeing Luann?
Oh, yeah. Now and then, you know, when the tide rises. Don't want her thinking it's some kind of exclusive deal, now do I?
Coach finds out you're nailing his daughter, you're gonna be playing dorm ball, buddy.
I'll bail before that. Besides, this is what Coach gets for not starting me.
You never learn, do you, Collins?
See, boys.
It's pathetic.
Alvin?
Hey, dog. You seen this?
Oh, my God.
You must be one badass motherfucker.
Like you didn't know.
Yeah, I knew there was gonna be an article, I just didn't know what was out already.
Shit. We do all the work, and you get all the pub. Too bad we ain't allowed to hit you in practice. Be fun to kick the shit out of a Heisman Trophy candidate.
Yeah, maybe you'll get your shot in the pros, huh?
Oh, yeah. Hey, beer boy. Give me some peanuts.
Are you serious?
Does it look like I'm serious?
This is one of those rookie things, right?
Listen to this. ESU has a solid nucleus returning, but the Timberwolves, coming off two disappointing seasons, will only go as far as the strong right arm of Heisman candidate Joe Kane will take them. Is that right, Joey? You gonna lead us to the promised land like that says?
Oh, yeah, I'm gonna lead. The question is, can you boys follow me?
Autumn! Yo, Autumn, wait up! It's me, Darnell.
Hey, Darnell.
Yo, what you doing here? I thought the students ain't come back for 2 weeks.
I came back early. See a friend.
That's cool. Yo, if I'm gonna say so myself, you are looking good. You look like a package of poultry tootin's, girl. Let's get together later tonight. Let's get some pizza. Let's kick it. Let's just hang out.
I can't tonight.
What about tomorrow night, then?
Darnell, I don't think it's a real good idea that we see each other.
Well, I'm not good enough for you all of a sudden. Oh, I'm too young, that's it, right? I'm not as young as you think I am. They held me back a year, you know?
That's not it.
What is it, then?
I have a boyfriend.
Did you have this boyfriend when you showed me around?
Yes.
Well, it didn't seem to bother you then. I'm willing to overlook it now.
I was mad at him then.
For what?
I caught him with another girl. A white girl.
A white girl? You still with this nigga? You won't give me no play?
Look, Darnell, I am really sorry. I didn't mean to lead you on in any way, but I'm really glad you came here. See ya.
Wait, hold up. I can at least walk with you, can I? Ain't no crime in that.
I'm in a hurry.
I can keep up. I run the 40 in 4.3.
Hey, Autumn.
Hey, Ray.
Where you been?
I was just talking to a friend of mine. Ray, this is...
Darnell Jefferson, tailback.
Ray Griffin, starting tailback.
Yeah, I know. That's why they recruited me.
The two boys they recruited before you are washing cars now. You better start strengthening your wrist.
This guy's kind of funny. Listen, man, just make sure and give your best to Miss Lily for me, all right? Stay black, bro.
When the hell is that supposed to mean?
21 minutes remaining in math section 2. 21 minutes.
Hey, let me get them scores back on that placement test.
Who cares? I flunked 3 times before I got in.
Long as you're in the program, they'll get you through. Maybe not with a degree, but they're gonna keep you eligible. Just don't do nothing embarrassing they can't cover you for.
Hell, they even give Alvin here copies of his tests in advance. He sells them for $100 a pop to people in his class. Of course, he still gotta have somebody read them to him.
Fuck you, doughboy. I can read. See that shoe? It says Adidas.
I taught him that.
Still in all, man. Promise Rev I get a degree. I don't want to let him down.
What do you think, nigga? You gonna be on the Supreme Court? All you need to know is how to sign an NFL contract. Period.
Yep.
I think both Joe and the university are best served by a straightforward Heisman campaign. Nothing too gimmicky.
In order to capitalize on the momentum created by the Sports Illustrated cover, we've compiled a mailing list of around 1,300 opinion makers, newspapers, football writers, sports anchors. First, we send them a packet on Joe and his achievements, bio stats plus human interest stuff, commitment to academics, charity work, etc. Then we update it each week with a postcard. Heisman voters hate opening envelopes.
Do you really think this is worth it? I mean, you think I got a shot at winning this thing?
Certainly. Plus, it's a good thing for the program. Publicizes the school, gives a boost to recruiting.
And it's a great thing for you. Jumps up your draft position, the size of your first contract, everything.
It's a great opportunity.
And all you've got to do is back it up on the field. And we have no doubts about that. Because we know... Cain is able.
Great!
No. Keep that index finger on the ball, all right?
Joe's too pumped up, trying to win a Heisman on every damn throw. I don't think he's ready for all this hype.
It's a little late to worry about that now. If we don't do something to follow up that Sports Illustrated cover, it's going to look like we don't believe in our own kids.
Hey, you let me worry about it, please?
Yeah! Say! Blue 80! Blue 80! Hut!
Too high, big boy. So long, sucker. Yeah.
Coming to get you, beer boy.
Come on.
Yeah. Lights out, baby.
Latimer.
You cut out that necktie tackle crap.
What are you trying to make a highlight reel? Huh? That man left you hogging air. You take this helmet and you put it right in his numbers, okay? Drive it through his guts. I want to see nothing but snot bubbles in his nose.
All right, let's move that drill down 15 yards. Let's go. Come on, boys.
All right, guys, let's go. Let's move it, guys. Offense, I left 29-10.
Jefferson, are you injured or are you hurt?
What does that mean?
Well, if you're hurt, you can still play. If you're injured, you can't. So are you hurt or are you injured?
I think I'm just hurt.
Well, that's good. And get up. Now, that was a hell of a run you just made. Think how good it would have been for us if you still had the ball. See, now this is a football. I want you to carry this with you always. Never let it out of your sight. Hey, boys! Listen! Jefferson here is going to be carrying this football on campus. Any one of you guys see him, I want you to try to slap it out of his hand. All right? Try to knock it out and recover it. Anybody but you. You turn this ball to me. You wish you were never born. All right, let's step it up. Welcome to the jungle. We got fun and games. Whatever you may need. Let's pick somebody now, right?
Come on, Dondale. He's got to be on something.
Steroids? How come you always think my guys are the ones juicing anyway?
He's on the punt return team for 3 years. Then he gains 35 pounds of rip in one summer and an attitude to go with it?
Gentlemen, we're not doctors. The NC2A has a testing program for this kind of thing. I suggest we let them handle it. And it's not that hard to gain 35 pounds over summer if you hit the gym real hard.
First day?
Cool.
Hey, bud.
Uh-huh.
How come you never asked me about my arm?
You have an arm? You want to hard on this for me? I'll meet you outside.
No problem. Don't strain yourself.
How you doing?
Fine.
A little late to be working out, isn't it?
It's the only time I could get in here when the football team wasn't using it.
Well, if it wasn't for the football team, you wouldn't have all this nice equipment to use. So what, are you firming up or what?
I'm up. I'm strengthening my knee. I had arthroscopic surgery.
Yeah, I had my knee scoped once, too. So, you want to go out for a beer or something after you're done?
I don't go out with football players. They're all full of themselves. I saw you on the cover of Sports Illustrated, so you're probably worse than most.
So you won't consider doing anything with me?
No.
All right, well, at least tell me what happened to your knee. What'd you do, fall to your convertible?
You know what? There is one thing that I might consider doing with you.
Oh, yeah? What's that?
Oh.
Shit.
Thanks for the game, Heisman. You took it real well.
I want a rematch.
A rematch?
Yeah, that's right. Some other sport. I mean, I took my beating, so you owe me one, right? Either that or you go out with me.
I'll think about it. And give me a call.
How'd I do?
That was a real good date, Joe. Remind me to take her out sometime.
Yo, my man, you can tell me where Gaines Hall is at?
It's at the end of Douglas Quad.
All right, thanks a lot, yo. Where the hell is Douglas Quad?
Darnell. I've reviewed your placement test, and I'm afraid you failed to meet our requirements in several areas.
Does this mean I can't play ball?
No, it means you're going to have to take some remedial courses. Specifically, Math 0, English 0, plus an American History Survey course. You won't get college credit for them, but they will help you prepare to take the placement test again at the end of the quarter. If you pass at that time, you'll be able to take regular college-level courses. But first things first. To start, I'm approving a tutor for you.
Tutor? I don't need no tutor.
Any tutor. And yes, you do.
What's up, boy?
Hey, Darnell. What are you doing here?
Ain't nothing. I'm just kicking it. I was talking to my advisor, and he seems to think I need a tutor just to get me over a couple of rough spots, that's all. I'm looking on this list right here, and I saw your name. I figured if you can't keep my attention, nobody can.
I'm sorry, Darnell, but you're gonna have to get yourself another tutor because I've already been assigned. I'm tutoring Scott Sherman.
Not anymore. Ask Coach Winters to switch us.
Coach Winters wouldn't do that.
Yes, he would. Yo, I'm a much bigger prospect than Scott Sherman. When you looking at him, look, he ain't nothing but a big, fat, pork rind-eating lineman on the scout team. Come on now, girl. You could teach me some real erudition, you know what I'm saying?
Will you stop using those big words? It makes you sound ridiculous.
What are you talking about? I'm improving myself every day. I learn a new word out of the dictionary. Mendacious, pejorative, antithetical, commensurate.
And you don't even know how to use them right. Pretending to be smart is not the same thing as being educated. It's just a con, and it makes you sound stupid. No matter how big a prospect you are.
Okay. But that's even more of a reason for you to be my tutor. You just taught me something.
Oh, Mr. Heisman. Joe, we've got a present for you.
Oh, no.
Carrying you as usual. Kind of looks like you, but not as skinny.
Joey. You're our hero.
Decided.
I don't know. I couldn't think of any other sports I could beat you at.
Well, then I'll pick you up tonight at 6.
What? We going on that?
Yeah, I thought we might take a little ride.
I promised my dad I'd never get on one of those.
What are you, one of those trust fund princesses? It's okay for me to play a game I don't know, but I ask you to try something different and you hide behind your daddy?
Okay. We go slow. No cowboy stuff.
Could have been ugly.
God damn!
Well, I've done that 100 times before. Never with anybody in the back, but it's fun, wasn't it?
You just wanted to scare me. Are you happy now?
Yeah. Actually, the scream was even better than I thought. You got just about every dog within hearing distance wanting to mate with you.
You come here a lot?
Now and then, why?
Well, it's not exactly a campus favorite. This is more like hiding out.
I like to go places where nobody knows me. Mine's just too low rent for you?
No. My father owned a place like this.
Your father?
Mm-hmm.
What, you mean he owned a chain of these?
No. You know, not everybody who plays tennis grew up in a country club, Joe. My dad could never afford to send me here. When I hurt my knee, I was afraid I was gonna lose my scholarship.
And so you're a full ticket jock, just like me?
Yeah, are you disappointed?
No, I just never went out with a jock before.
Is that what's going on here? We're going out?
What do you think?
I think you're crazy for jeopardizing your scholarship and a pro career by jumping motorcycles off of highways.
Just trying to keep my edge. See, the guys, they look to me because they think I'll do anything. If I lose that, then I'm just another guy. And we all get the shit kicked out of us.
You scare me, Joe.
I told you during the season, no unnecessary risks. Any guy that's up for the Heisman should be able to remember that, no? Night.
I
Now, using the things we worked on yesterday, I want you to write a 2 or 3 page essay about some aspect of your life, other than football.
What's in my life besides football?
I don't know. Your father. You could write about your dad.
I don't know much about him. He was off in Detroit working in a car plant when I was born. Got laid off. Tried to rob a liquor store to get us some money. Got caught. Died in prison. Some kind of heart problem.
Well, maybe you can write about your mother.
She was usually working 2 jobs. One night, she stopped at a grocery store to get me some root beer. She got caught in gang crossfire. Shot 3 times. Died on the way to the hospital. You want me to write about that?
No.
That's good, because ain't none of that true.
Gee whiz, Darnell. What kind of thing is that to do to somebody? It's not funny.
I had you going, didn't I?
No, you did not have me going. Why would you make up something like that?
Sounded more interesting than the truth. I never knew who my dad was. When I was 12, my mother took a vacation in Chicago and never came back.
Well, then, maybe just this once, you can write about football.
Seen a lot of shitty things in life, Autumn. That's why I know when I see something good.
Okay, let's review the chapter I read you yesterday. Which 2 city-states fought in the Punic Wars?
I don't know. Detroit and Buffalo?
Oh, come on, Alvin. You're gonna be tested on this.
Brookers, you pay attention. This is what I expect out of you. Alvin, you ready?
Yes, sir.
All right, this is Mississippi State's offensive set. 2nd and 2 on our own 24. What defensive set might we call?
Eagle zipper hero, unless a setback shifts into the eye.
Good. 3rd and 7.
Okie Thunder Lion.
What's your assignment?
Kill the quarterback. Hit the tight end so hard his girlfriend dies. Kill everybody.
Here you go. Ready? Very nice game. Well, you owe me a dinner. But you're taking it real well.
Now, George Washington won a few skirmishes, but he never actually won a real battle. Still, he won the war.
Shit! Fumble!
What is going on?
Oh, spy! I got it, man! I got it! Come on,
sir, you see?
Come here, come here!
Unacceptable behavior!
Gentlemen, return! Get in there! Got it, punk! Get your butt on my face!
She's gonna wait for you.
You lucky, chump. Get you slipping.
Sorry. I lost my ball.
Are you in there, baby?
Starting defense. Place at the table.
Looks like Joe's coming around. He should be ready for Saturday.
Place at the table. Yeah. Yeah.
Jesus. I think we ought to tell Coach.
Hell no, you don't want to know about this.
Yeah. Make sure you tell Latimer that the NCAA will be testing on Saturday.
Yeah, baby! Starting defense!
As my upperclassmen know, we have Pride Night every year before our opening game. So I'd like each of you to talk about what you like best about football and what you're most proud of off the field. Now, I've asked some of my veterans here to start.
Latimer?
I don't know. It's the battle. The going to war with the other guys.
Sid!
Hanging together.
Lee!
Having our own dorm. Staying in hotels the night before the games. Setting ourselves apart. Being different than everybody else. Having a chance to be somebody. To do something that people look up to you for. Your strength. Your courage. Not everybody can play football. We're the lucky ones. The thing that I'm most proud of myself for, just that I'm here. Not in jail or dead. I ain't no statistic.
Well, the great thing about football is that you can lose yourself in it. There's no time to think or to worry. You just move and react. Well, everything else fades away.
Best thing is when you hit a guy. You know it's killing it. But you feel great. It's just him and you. And he's the one that's hurt.
Everybody to the Wolf Den, where the ESU Timberwolves, led by Heisman Trophy candidate Joe Kane, open their season against the Mississippi State Bulldogs. The Bulldogs have won the toss, so the T-Wolves will be kicking off. And we are underway. Kick coming down to Tyler in the end zone. He's going to bring it out. Back to the 15. To the 20. Brought down at the 22-yard line by Powell and Ellsworth. Now we'll see how the ESU defense, led by All-American linebacker Alvin Mack, does in its first test of the season.
All right! Hit squad is in the house!
Yeah, it's party time, baby!
All right now, baby, all right. 60 minutes falls out. Let's open up the whole can of kick-ass and kill them all. Let the paramedics sort them out. Raise up Bear Claw Stinger. Ready?
Bulldogs coming to the line of scrimmage. T-Wolves in their standard 4-3.
Hey, 23? Don't think I don't recognize you, poop butt motherfucker. Hey, pay attention when I'm talking to you, nigga.
What?
You're the guy who shot my mother, aren't you?
Shut up, man. You knew I never knew your mother.
You were trying to steal a fucking car, you cocksucker. You didn't think I was gonna find you, did you? But I got you now, nigga. I'm gonna bust your gut open and watch you die!
Lock pitches to Tyler, sweeping left.
Say your prayers!
Mack cuts him off.
Oh, shit.
Come back here, you little pussy!
Oh, Tyler, crunched by Latimer, fumble!
That's mine! That's mine!
Dar ball!
They unstack him, and ESU has got it.
Hell yeah! Hell yeah! All
right!
You think, baby!
Come on, let's go up top. Get to him right away. ZQ motion, let's go.
So we'll see what Kane does here as the Wolves attempt to capitalize on the turnover.
Let's take it to him now. Trips right, motion, Z3. Let's put the women and children to bed and go looking for dinner, boys. On four, ready?
Right! Yep.
Yippee-ki-yay-yo, get along, little doggies. It's your misfortune and none of my own.
Shut up, Snowflake. You think you're on Star Search?
Nope. We're running doggies into the end zone, and the trail runs right over your ass.
Bullshit. You gonna be my bitch. You gonna be my punk bitch, baby.
Game fades back to pass.
You'll never be half the man your mama was. It's your misfortune now, fat boy. Take this. Eat it. Kill it. Love it.
Looking downfield, Ward has a step on his man. Kane going for it all. Fires for Flea Ward in the end zone. Great catch. Touchdown, ESU.
Excuse me, my doggies just reached the end zone and I gotta do some celebrating.
Fuck you!
Yeah! Yeah, that's it!
On the
that's
money, it. Baby! It was there! Right there!
Hell of a pass, man! Wish I'd seen it!
2:05 left in the game. Wolves up 28-20.
In there for Griffin.
Darnell Jefferson making his first appearance at tailback. Kane brings him up to the line of scrimmage. Hands to Jefferson up the middle, out to the 35, 36-yard line. Nice gain for the freshman, who had a little bit of fumbleitis in fall practice.
Hey, excuse me, son, but we're going to be needing that football for another couple of minutes.
Right. Right. 8 seconds left, last chance for Mississippi State. Luck fades back to pass. Latimer coming from the left side. Oh! He almost takes Locke's head off.
Looks like you lost your bonnet, baby! Yeah! Yeah! Oh!
Yeah! And that'll do it. The game is over. As the 93 season gets off to a good start for the Timberwolves with a 28-20 win over the Mississippi State Bulldogs.
Get to keep the car, got the house for another week.
This performance today, two touchdown passes, another you ran in. Where do you think this puts you in the Heisman race?
Well, I really don't know about that. That's up to you guys.
This way, please.
And now, let's turn to our Heisman watch. We begin with Sports Illustrated cover boy Joe Kane of ESU, who led his team to an impressive victory this afternoon. Well, the real test will come in 4 weeks against Michigan and their Heisman hopeful, Tim Wayman. Tim, he could go all the way, man. We'll be looking to do so against the Timberwolves. And, of course, the Abel Kane will be looking to do so as well.
Hey, Darnell. Did a really great job out here today. Way to hold on to that pigskin.
Thank you.
A little something for you. Keep up the good work.
Played a hell of a game, son.
Thank you.
I'm proud of you.
Let me talk to you for a second.
Thanks again.
Yo, some guy just gave me $50, man.
Don't worry. You'll get about $500 or $600 once you start. Depending on how you plan.
But I thought we're not supposed to take any money. Ain't that a violation?
You cannot live on no $500 a month scholarship money. And the NCAA assholes won't let us have jobs. So you take your money where you can get it. As a matter of fact, let me hold this for you till you see light. Shit. Ought to be paying us anyway. Athletic department gets $3 million just for going to a bowl game.
Thank you.
chance for you there.
How you figure?
Griffin's going to medical school. She likes that light-skinned, respectable shit. You just a ghetto dog.
Can I have this one?
Yeah, I don't think so.
What you worried about, boy? You haven't lost your starting job just yet.
Hey, you got a problem,
Ray,
with it?
Just one, okay? Just one.
Yeah, just one.
Take it easy, Darnell. You are putting me in a very awkward situation here.
Got a little encouragement along the way. Listen, I want to see you, Autumn. Not in the study hall. Not like a student. I want to be taken seriously.
Darnell, I do take you seriously. But if you haven't noticed, I'm still with Ray. And I cannot just go parading around town with you.
You don't have to go parade. You can go someplace different. Someplace that nobody will see us.
Why am I even considering this? It's crazy.
Hey, genius. You all caught up on your arithmetic?
Yeah, yeah. You only gained 37 yards on
12 carries. Hey, cool down. Hey, you want some of this? Come on. Hey.
Easy.
Come on.
Be cool.
Just call me, baby. But now,
so much for team unity, huh?
Yeah.
You didn't have anything to do with that, did you?
Hell no. You know me.
Hey, we need to talk. Look, I'm getting a little sick of that asshole, Autumn. I don't like you hanging out with him. It's embarrassing.
I don't hang out with him. I tutor him.
Then have him get another tutor.
I can't do that. I promised him I'd help him pass his qualifying exam, and I can't go bailing out on him now.
What the hell difference does it make? They'll grease him through no matter what he does. Nobody's ever going to see that boy graduate. Hey, don't tell me you're falling for this guy. He's nothing. He's just another gangbanger with speed.
I'm trying to help him out. What are you more afraid of, Ray? Losing your girl or your position?
And maybe you ought to think a little bit more about what you're in danger of losing.
Well, maybe I will. So where you want to go?
You gotta make it all the way around them just once, girl.
You're right, Donna. I don't think anybody would find us here.
Yeah, I figured the key is to go places only white people go. I think next time we'll go bowling. Plus, I saw this in Rocky, yo. I always used to wonder how a guy who's supposed to be such a great athlete escaped so fast.
Nice form, Jefferson. You all right?
Thank you, Darnell. This was fun. Well, sort of fun.
You was good for your first time. Huh?
Well, actually, this isn't my first time. My dad took me skating once when I was little.
Yeah, your pops used to play ball for ESU, didn't he?
Yeah. How do you know?
I saw his picture on the Wall of Fame. There you got his eyes. Luckily, you ain't get his thighs.
I know.
Make sure you mean it, all right?
Excuse me. What's your name?
Bobby Collins.
Could I see your ID, please?
You took someone else's test. Damn it, Luann. I mean, how could you be so stupid? Stupid!
He was behind. He needed help. I'm sorry. I just...
Sorry? I mean, you weaken my authority with the players. It looks like I'm running a dirty program. And Bobby Collins, of all people. Bobby Collins, why?
I don't know. I thought that he loved me.
Loved you? Loved you. This guy loves anything that wears a skirt. This little rat bastard. Now you're both expelled. I try to use my influence to get you back in, it just destroys my credibility with the university. I just can't.
I don't want you to. I'll get in someplace.
in, Collins. Come in.
Coach. Listen, I just want you to know that I'm real sorry about this whole thing with Luann. I was real glad to hear she's going to be going to junior college here.
Shut up. I could pull some strings to help you out here, but I won't. You've embarrassed the school, you've embarrassed me, and you've embarrassed my family. So as of now, you are no longer a member of this university or its football team. Now go clean out your locker. You get out of here before I knock the piss out of you.
Have you seen this? You got a D on your math test.
Kind of figured that. Had some trouble on the last part.
Darnell, we went over this entire chapter last week. Look, I thought you wanted to learn, but if all you want to do is fake your way through, then you're going to have to find yourself another tutor and waste her time.
Autumn, we just had a good time. Why are you getting all riled up about one test?
So far, it's the only test.
Look, I don't wish to be cast in a pejorative light. Therefore, I'm dedicating myself to achieving on a level more commensurate with my abilities.
You're amazing.
All right, Joe, relax. Look right at me. Pay no attention to the camera, okay?
Okay.
Ready? All right, here we go. Joe, this game is being billed as a potential Heisman shootout. Did you feel any additional pressure this week knowing that you'd be going head-to-head with Heisman rival Tim Wehman?
Well, I'd be lying if I said I didn't. I mean, you try to block it out, but it's basically impossible, you know? I mean, everybody seems to be talking about it. The radios, the newspapers, and all the interviews, you know? And then there's the TV, always trying to get some sort of hype going.
Hold it.
Sharon, what are you doing?
What you're saying is true, of course, but I don't think it's the message you want to send. It makes you seem a little nervous. My pressure might be getting to you. This game is nationally televised, so most Heisman voters will be watching. I think a more casual approach is better. Controlled, modest, casual.
All right, make this take two. Here we go, Joe, this game is being billed as a potential Heisman shootout. Did you feel any additional pressure this week knowing you'd be going head-to-head against Heisman rival Tim Wehman?
Well, to tell you the truth, Lynn, I hadn't really thought about it.
So there you have it, folks. Joe Kane remains unfazed before his battle against Heisman rival Tim Wehman. Oddsmakers have installed Michigan as a 3-point favorite, but the Timberwolves will have the advantage of playing in the friendly confines of Wolfden Stadium.
Hello, Dad? No, I was just calling because Michigan game's on TV tomorrow and I thought you might want to watch it. It's broke? Well, can't you go over to Jackie B's and watch it with Jerry? Oh. No, fine. Well, then, I hope you feel better. Yeah. Bye.
Are your parents coming to the game tomorrow?
My mom died when I was young. My dad's never seen me play.
Why not?
I don't know. I guess he doesn't like football.
You're one of the best players in the country.
He's just not into it, okay?
Okay.
Kane fades back. Jesus, man. Bad hands.
What's going on, Joe? You asked me out here like you want to talk about something, but you're not saying anything. Are you worried about tomorrow?
What do I have to be worried about? I'm a Heisman candidate, remember?
Joe, why are you thinking like this? You're having a great year. You've got millions of dollars waiting for you in the pros.
How do you know what's waiting for me? You don't even know me.
I don't know you? How could you say that?
Because if you did, you wouldn't be with me. You only know the guy's supposed to be making millions in the pros.
That's what you think, that I'm with you for the money?
I don't know why you're with me.
Fuck you. You know, maybe you're right. Maybe I don't know you. Shit.
You should have got away from me while you still had the chance.
I don't want to get away from you. What's wrong, Joe?
I'm a king, Camille. We're just a bunch of drunks and fuck-ups. It's what we do. It's in our blood. My dad, my uncles, my brothers. We all drink, and sooner or later, we all fuck up. Sometimes I just feel like I'm waiting for my turn.
You don't have to be like them. You can give all that up.
Then what? Then what would I be?
You'd still be Joe. And that's enough.
.429 to go, and it's been a great one. Two undefeated teams going after each other. Michigan up by 4, 24-20. But the lead has changed hands three times. And, Bo, you get the feeling that whoever has the ball last is going to win it.
Well, it's been billed as a Heisman Trophy shootout, and it's been all of that.
Third down and 8, ESU at the Michigan 20. Kane back to pass. Can't find anybody. Gets away. Gonna run it himself. At the 10, 5. Touchdown, ESU. What a run by Kane. And Kane is still down. He took quite a shot from Ryan.
You all right?
Sit him up. Are you sure you feel okay?
Yeah.
Let's stand him up.
You probably just get the wind knocked out of him. It was a hell of a run, man. How's the head?
Fine.
ESU in an 8-man line looking for the run on third and short.
Ready!
Hey, butterfuck. You white boy riding my brother out, send him to jail.
Blue, 30.
Get that fucking money, you huh? Left the blood to do the time.
Six, yeah. You the little bastard. Johnny, you my brother, sitting in his cellmate. I'm gonna make you pay. You hear me, Bob Buff? I'm gonna make you my cellmate.
Mayday! Mayday!
You're gonna have 250 pounds of pissed off nigga up your ass.
Mac on the blitz.
Pass, pass!
Layman's going for it all. Hunt's got a step. He's got it. Touchdown, Michigan.
This is our house now, dog!
Steve, that was a great clutch throw under pressure. You just can't do it much better than that.
You right, Doc?
Yep.
You ready to go?
Yeah.
Sure?
Yeah, it's got a little headache.
All right, come on, let's go.
Let's go! All right, come on, now, let's go. Let's get it back. Get it up. Come on, man.
Ray, come here.
Jefferson, in the series, go.
Fuck is...
Take that. Take it out.
Ball at the Michigan 47, 102 to play, as Kane brings them to the line of scrimmage. They shift to the I formation.
Brown 34!
Kane back to pass. Setting up the screen. It's the Darnell Jefferson who has blockers.
Right there. Come on.
Bumped out of bounds at the 20. Great run by Jefferson.
Stick, baby. You ain't got nothing for me. Hit me harder than that. Come with it, baby. They don't want none.
Nice run, baby. Nice run. Okay, listen up. I write P25, tailback scene. Let's put the women and children to bed and go looking for dinner. On two. Ready? Burn!
ESU first and 10 at the 20, just 34 seconds remaining. Kane, play action. Pressure from the backside. Looking for Jefferson. It's intercepted. Intercepted by Whitney. And that should do it. Well, it was everything we expected it to be. Fine performances, Bo, on both sides of the field. The edge in a much ballyhooed battle of the quarterbacks would probably have to go to Michigan's Tim Wayman. Joe Kane accounted for two ESU touchdowns, but had that crucial interception in the waning moments, and that proved to be the difference.
Where's Kane? Where's Joe Kane?
What's up, Autumn?
Hey, Darnell.
How you doing?
Good.
This must be your father.
Yeah, this is my dad, Lou Haley.
Darnell Jefferson.
Jefferson, nice run you made on that screen pass. Another block you might have scored.
Yeah, get him next year.
How do you and Autumn know each other? You a friend of Ray's?
No. Actually, I tutor Darnell.
Oh, really? In what?
Math and English.
Well, stay on top of that, Darnell. I'd have been in real trouble if I hadn't gotten my degree. I played ball once. I used to put a copy of my report card inside the webbing of my helmet to remind me that college was more important than football.
It's a good idea. If you'd excuse me, I gotta get going. Nice to meet you, sir.
Nice to meet you, Darnell. Hey, Ray.
Hey, Mr. Haley. Good to see you.
Still having dinner with us tonight?
Yes, sir. I wouldn't miss it.
That's a tough loss today, man.
Yeah. Yeah, I thought we had him.
Wait. I think we'd better get back downstairs.
Leslie, we're just getting to know each other.
No, I better go. Hey!
We didn't come up here to stop.
What are you doing?
Father's a big booster, contributes a lot of money. So he says they won't go to the press.
He said that, Father?
Yeah. I mean, he's not exactly happy about all this, but he doesn't want to hurt the program.
We're still going to have to suspend him, boys.
Coach, he's never tested positive. If we suspend him now without any proof, hell, he could sue us for jeopardizing his draft status.
Well, what are we supposed to do, sit around and wait till he kills somebody?
3 games. Why so many?
So many? You're lucky I didn't suspend you for the whole season.
What are you going to give us a reason?
We're going to tell him you pulled a hamstring.
Thank you, Coach.
Oh, don't thank me. You got 3 weeks. 3 weeks to kick these roids, because when you come back, it's not going to be any of that NCAA crap. I am going to personally test you before every game. I mean, watch it go in a bottle. You got that?
Yes, sir. I'm sorry about all this.
Go on, go practice your limp.
Couple real college heroes, huh? This is the first time I lost a game and a girl in the same fucking day, man. I guess if you think about it, I never really had a girl.
You know that guy?
Not really.
And why are you smiling at him?
I don't know. He looks like that ESU quarterback guy. Joe, what's his name?
So what? So you go and smile at him?
I wasn't really...
I feel like an ink spot in a bowl of milk, man. Let's get out of here.
Hey, you looking at my girl?
I don't know. Which one is she?
Wise guy, huh? Mr. Big Time quarterback? The one who choked his ass off today?
Yeah, I'm really not in the mood.
What, do you got nothing better to do than look at my girl? Hey, Heisman, I'm talking to you. I said I'm talking to you, Heisman. What, are you too good to talk to me?
Yeah, but I'm not too good to tear a new hole in your towny ass.
Think you're a badass, huh?
Yeah.
You think my girl's hot for you?
Probably.
Let me tell you something. Take off your pants, you're nothing but another pussy.
Drunk ass down? Damn, Bud wouldn't like you driving his truck like this any fucking way.
Bud won't care. He doesn't even know I have it.
Shit! Shit! Perfect ending to a fucked up day.
It hit every newspaper, every wire service. The guy had to go to the hospital. Let him make things worse. You get picked up for drunk driving. Now, I just can't clean this stuff up. I had to agree to send you to rehab.
Rehab? Well, that's fucking... I'm gonna be a fucking joke. Why don't you fix this like you fix everything else?
No, I can't. It's the only way I can get him to drop the DWI and the assault. We risk a definite NC2A investigation. Hey, you go to trial, I lose you for a whole year.
You know how many athletes have gone to rehab?
I'm in the middle of a Heisman campaign.
All right, so you miss 4 games. You come back in time for the last one, which is Georgia Tech, and then possibly a bowl game. And you got your whole senior year.
Jesus.
You make the best of this, Joe.
I mean, stuff happens.
Darnell! 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 Wait up! Hey, I've been trying to call you. Where you been?
I've been busy.
Hey, if it's about Saturday, I'm sorry. It was just a real awkward situation.
No, it wasn't awkward, Autumn. It was educational. I realize how you see me now. I'm good enough to tutor. I'm good enough to go places with, but I'm not good enough to tell your father about
it. Darnell, that is not it. My father expects me to be with somebody like Ray, all right? He wouldn't understand us.
Why? Because he's a good student. I'm not. Because he acts right, I don't. Because he doesn't need football, I do. Because he's class, and I'm not, right?
Darnell, I didn't say that.
You don't have to say that, Autumn. I'm everything your father used to be and don't want you falling back into.
Darnell.
Look, you was right from jump. I should have got another tutor. Thanks for everything you did for me.
Hey, bud, is it true what I'm hearing? Joe's out 4 fucking weeks?
Yeah, shit.
Defense is gonna have to pitch shutouts now.
And you're going for 3?
What the hell did you take that shit for?
Nobody seemed to mind when I was laying people out.
Should I bust chops too? You don't see me all fucked up.
Not everybody has your ability, Alvin. You do what you have to do to play.
Well, you're not playing much now, are you? Shit. Whole fucking season down the drain.
Yeah?
You have a phone call? A Camille Schaefer? She says she's your girlfriend?
I don't want to talk to her right now.
I'm sorry, he doesn't wish to speak to you right now.
Well, what's he saying now?
Well, with Joe out, everything could be up for grabs again.
Well, what is it that you're trying to say?
You gotta get Bobby Collins back from Raven.
Can Wilson say that?
No, the pressure's coming from the alumni. Wilson's not gonna stand in the way, though.
Yeah, well, forget it.
Hey, come on, Sam. Look, I know he's no all-star, for Christ's sake, but he's good enough to give us a split over the next 4 games.
This is my program, and I'll decide who plays. Oh,
give me that high and mighty bullshit. There are a lot of people on the bubble here, Coach. 4 straight losses, and we're out of bowl contention. Now, how the hell is that going to make you look?
There are 4 members of the board. I respectfully submit that Bobby Collins should not be given special treatment just because he's a football player. Would a regular student get a reinstatement hearing if they've been caught cheating? Nobody's talking about letting the young woman who took the test back in.
I think it's also instructive to look at some of the courses this young man has taken. Beginning golf, voice and speech improvement.
I would like to point out that Mr. Collins was still right on schedule to receive his degree.
In what? Swimming pool management?
Would you like to respond, Coach Winters?
What's that, sir?
Would you like to respond?
Yes. I don't know a whole lot about this stuff here, but I do know that the punishment should fit the crime. That cheating's bad. And I don't believe that, you know, it deserves a lifelong sentence. Now, Here we have a student athlete who's taking college level courses, wants to graduate. He's made a mistake. Bobby here's made a mistake. And he's been suspended for several weeks, so I think he's served his time and deserves a second chance.
Like Alvin Mack? We gave him a second chance. Since he's had 5 incompletes, 4 withdrawals, and still reads at a 4th grade level.
If you don't reinstate Bobby, or you hadn't admitted Alvin, you would have taken away their futures. And in Alvin's case, that could cost them millions of dollars in the pros.
But this is not a football vocational school. It's an institute of higher learning.
Yeah, but when was the last time 80,000 people showed up to see a kid do a damn chemistry experiment? Why don't you stick the bow tie up your ass?
Gentlemen, please.
Sorry.
Let's get back to the business at hand. Bobby Collins. As you know, I played football here. And I remember how hard it was to practice and then study when you're dead tired. So I have some sympathy for this young man. But I never cheated. So the real question is his character. Now, since you know him better than anyone else in this room, and having talked to him and observed him over the last several weeks, do you think he's learned his lesson? In other words, can you vouch for his character?
Yes. Yes, I can.
So the Wolves, despite a sputtering offense, edged the Boston College Eagles today 14-10. ESU stayed mostly on the ground as the passing game was largely ineffective. Look only, be all that I can be. Say I can say words only simple. That'll do it from here, as ESU was blanked this afternoon by a very tough Texas team, 13-0. The Wolves' defense, led by Alvin Mack, kept them in it, but turnovers led to both Longhorn scores. Wanting love is all that I feel when you're passing by. Wanting love is all that I see. It's there in your eyes. Well, ESU, on the strength of a 62-yard touchdown run by steadily improving freshman Darnell Jefferson, squeaks by the North Carolina Tar Heels today, 14-13, keeping their once-fading bowl hopes very much alive.
Hey!
Get past the tough Iowa Hawkeyes team in their last game before the return of Joe Kane.
All set to go now. Thick Ben, the remaining setback.
Snow Dog. Damn, I know you, motherfucker. You one got my baby sister pregnant. Wait, seen you around lately. Where you been, huh? Oh, come on, don't punk out behind that mask now. Answer me, motherfucker, before I peel your gap. Go.
Dixon pitches to Thigpen, sweeping left. Mack chasing the play. Thigpen cuts back. Mack pursues inside. Oh, he's leveled by Morgan. And Mack is down. He's hurt. They're gathered around him. The doctor is coming out. We can only hope this is not serious.
All right, Alvin, just hang in there.
Oh, shit!
Thank
you. Oh, my, this does not look good. They're bringing the stretcher out.
Twelve seconds left. Iowa driving for the winning touchdown. Fourth and goal at the one. ESU trying to hold on without their star middle linebacker, Alvin Mack. Dixon calling signals. Turns, Hands to Thigpen, straight ahead off right tackle. Latimer meets him at the goal line. Thigpen pulls his way into the end zone. Touchdown, Iowa. Latimer had him, but just couldn't hold him as Iowa pulls out a last-second victory, 14-10.
Coach, you've lost two of your last four. Why do your team seem to nosedive at the end of the last couple seasons?
Tonight was a tough loss, but it wasn't a nosedive. We've had a few key players out. We lost another great one tonight. But I thought you guys would know that if we won next week, we'd still be conference champs and go to a major bowl. See, I always knew you guys couldn't write, but I thought at least you could count.
Hey, Coach. How you feeling?
All right.
You're looking pretty good.
Yeah.
Hey, any guys come down to see you?
They call.
You know, football players are about hospitals and injuries.
Yeah. I'm never gonna play again, am I?
Doctors aren't always right. Either way, I want you to know that you're the best damn defensive player I ever coached.
Seen him since the last night I saw you. Well, I just came by to see how your studying was coming. Ready for tomorrow?
Hope so. I've been studying pretty hard.
Good. Good. I talked to my dad last night.
How's he doing?
Fine.
Tell him I said hello.
Talked about you.
What'd you say?
Well, I told him that we'd gone out. And that I wished I could still go bowling.
Man, good to have you back.
Good to be back.
What's up, brother? Next game, we blow some people up.
Oh, yeah.
Did you get any throwing done in there?
Nah, all they got is ping pong.
Nah. Here, get an aerial view.
Hey, Joe.
Flat. Watch your boots on the truck bay.
Hi. How you doing?
Fine.
Good.
You all right now?
Yeah, I think so. Got a few loose ends to tie up, but,
Good, I'm happy for you.
Hey. I'm sorry that I, you know, that I didn't want to... that I couldn't see you.
You couldn't even talk to me.
I was embarrassed. I couldn't...
It's enough of the ass. Let's run some deeper digs.
All right, quarterbacks. Run your deeper crossing patterns next.
Hey!
Oh, he's rusty, Sam. I doubt if we're going to start him.
Yeah, his head's just not back into it.
Boys, I thought we'd try something a little different for this game. Maximize our speed and keep you both in the lineup at the same time. So, Ray, we're moving you over to fullback. Darnell, you'll be our starting tailback. Now, not everybody can handle a transition like this, Ray. I think you're up to it.
Yes. Yes, sir.
Good. That's good.
What's this, they throw you out?
No.
I heard about your little set to the end of the news here.
Yeah.
So, what are you doing here?
Just been thinking about some things.
Yeah, that's what the damn rehab will do. Make you think about a lot of things you can't do nothing about.
I'm wondering why you never came to any of my games.
I don't know. Maybe I didn't want to make you nervous. I might have tried too hard and screwed up.
Yeah, I might have done real good. How would that have made you feel?
What do you mean?
It might have made you feel bad, like maybe you could have been something more if you tried a little harder.
Maybe I didn't want to see you get all excited, all pumped up with pride. I knew one day it'd all come crashing down, just like it did.
Yeah, I'm still here, ain't I? Got one more game left this season. I don't know how much I'll play, or if I'll play at all, but I'd like you to be there.
How would you feel about introducing your drunken dad to your friends? You think about that?
Oh, I could deal with it if you could. This is a plane ticket. A ticket for the game, 50-yard line seat.
What's this doing again?
Just taking the dope urine out of your bladder and putting clean back in. Call it an oil change.
We are gonna get it done today! We're gonna ring the bell today!
Let's do this.
is what you guys been working for.
I need 60 minutes. 60 minutes of me!
You got it.
60 minutes! No business, no mercy! Nothing but stunts on the sun bubble! You got me! We're gonna ring the bell! We're gonna ring that championship bell!
Ding! Motherfucking dong!
Wolves moving left to right on your radio dial. They've had trouble scoring the last few weeks with Bobby Collins at the helm. Despite Joe Kane's return, Collins gets the starting nod again.
All right, let's get this off to a good start. I 28, Thunder right, second blue. Ready, play! Right.
Okay, tight left. Wolves in the eye with a new look.
Set.
Jefferson set. Now starting at tailback.
Blue.
Griffin 80. At full.
Watch right, baby, watch right!
Blue!
Collins pitches to Jefferson, sweeping on Thunder right.
46, 46.
Griffin leading the blocking. And, oh, Hugh goes right by him. Oh, fumble. It looks like Georgia Tech has the ball. And a tough break for the Wolves, as the Yellow Jackets will have excellent field position.
All right, let's go defense. Put your helmets on the belly.
Damn it.
Shit. Punk ass grip.
OP offense. Tough break. Tough break. It was there, we just didn't execute. You gotta finish your blocks. Finish them off. Next time we get it, we take control. Jefferson, you gotta squeeze the ball, you understand? You gotta put it away.
So the Wolves defense has held after the fumble, and the Yellow Jackets will opt for the field goal. It's around a 34-yarder. Here's the snap. Ball is down. It's away. It's long enough. And it's good. The Georgia Tech Yellow Jackets jump out on top, 3-0. 25 seconds left in the half. Collins is going to have to go to the air if the Wolves hope to get on the board here before halftime. Collins fades back to pass.
Don't throw the flag!
Looking in the flat for Ward. The ball is tipped, batted around, intercepted by Woolley. Down the sideline. 20, 15, 10. Touchdown, Georgia Tech. And it looks like the Yellow Jackets will go in at halftime with a 10-0 lead.
Come on, guys. We're only down 10. Now let's get our fucking shit together and kick some fucking ass.
Guys, now we got 30 minutes of football left. 30 minutes. The second half is ours.
Yo, motherfucker. Missed that block on purpose, right?
Hey, you full of shit. You fumble, you try to blame me.
All the shit is over Autumn, ain't it?
Fuck Autumn and fuck you. You just can't take a hit, punk.
I don't want to hear about who started it. Save it for the field. You understand me?
Do you understand me?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
The rest of you guys, you play that second half the way you did the first. This is what the rest of your season's gonna look like.
Don't ever let me see you miss a block again.
Yeah, coach.
Joe. Warm yourself up. You're starting second half.
Yeah.
Yeah. All right. Yeah. No, come on.
Yeah, Joe.
Oh, Collins.
Yeah, coach.
Get a mop and clean that mess up.
You gotta be kidding me.
Ready to go with the second half now. The Wolves trailing 10-0. We're told Joe Kane will be starting at quarterback. Kane calling signals. Fumbles. Griffin recovers.
Come on, Joe.
Green, 25.
Kane looking for Jefferson in the flat. Under throws it badly. Kane fading to pass.
Hit and sacked.
And Kane's return is a rocky one so far.
Joe's too tentative, too cautious out there. He's flat, Sam. Maybe we ought to go.
He's gonna be all right. He's gonna get his feel back. Be all right.
But Sam, we can't afford to wait.
I said he's gonna be all right.
5:51 to go. Georgia Tech up 10-0. The Wolves are gonna have to find some offense in a hurry here. Their defense has been keeping them in it.
Come on, Joe. Not let it go, man. Where's that wild man that used to take charge of this team here? Huh? Hell, I know you ain't lost that. You are the only one these guys are gonna follow. It's time to sit at the head of the table. Let's forget rehab. Forget your dad. There's 10 guys out there waiting for you. It's your family now. Look at me, boy. We need you. We need you. You're the man, Joe. You go out there and you play like I know you can, all right?
So let's see what the Wolves come up with here as time continues to tick away.
All right, we've held these guys up long enough now.
All right, the masked man is back. Hi-ho, fucking Silver.
Give me some time back here and I'll pick them apart. Strong left, Brown right, 60 pass on three. Ready? Bang!
Kane back to pass. Good protection. Throws to Jefferson on the sideline. He's got it and out of bounds at the Yellow Jacket 32. Kane fades again. Fires for Griffin. Leaping catch at the 21 as the Timberwolves are beginning to roll. Kane looks into the end zone. Can't find anybody. Gonna run it. Tucks the ball. 20. 15. 10. Kane gets it to the 4, where it'll be first and goal. And there's no doubt about it, with 3:45 remaining, they've got to score here if they want to get back in this game.
Hey, Coach, give it to me up the gut. They've been ignoring me. I can score. I know I can.
Now we're going to sweep. 28th under right. Go.
Go right. Go offense. Do it.
Coach wants our right 28 pitch.
All right. Thunder right, 28 pitch, on one, on one. Ready?
Bam!
Red, 21!
Kane pitches to Jefferson. Sweeping thunder right. Griffin, the lead blocker, falls down.
Shit!
Jefferson hemmed in at the sideline. Tries to cut back. Whoa, what a great block by Griffin. Jefferson driving through the end zone.
Come on, Ash, come on.
Touchdown, Timberwolves.
Yes. All right, baby, we're back in it.
Yeah, yeah.
Hey, nice block, man. Hell of a run, Rook. Hell of a fucking run.
Let's take it to him, baby. We're taking it to him.
Okay, defense, let's get even. Let's kill them all. Put the paramedics, sort them out.
111 and counting. Third and one.
The Wolves will have to stop them on this play if they're going to get the ball back. A first down, and it's all she wrote. ESU is out of timeouts.
All right, defense, let's stuff him one time for Alvin. 4-3 stack. Ready?
Georgia Tech over the ball. Tom calling signals.
8-1-8! 8-1-8! Whoa! Yeah. Pat!
hands off to Garrick.
You're a dead man!
Stops Garrick for a 2-yard loss.
I don't think you got it, pal.
And the Wolves will get the ball back. Great individual effort by Latimer.
Man.
Georgia Tech in punt formation. Here's the snap. Langham puts the foot to it. Jefferson.
Showtime, baby.
Settles under it.
Go.
Starts right.
Bring it to me.
No place to go. Reverses his field. Comes back left.
Come with me. Come with me.
Looking for the sideline. Great block by Gibson.
Right there. 23.
Good. A great crack back by Hughes.
Yeah. 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 Going. Yeah.
Another big block. One man to beat. Yeah. Knocked out of bounds at the 20-yard line.
Offense, go.
Time to play. All right, end zone's not open. You take the sideline, all right?
All right. Come on, baby. Come on.
17 seconds to go. No timeouts for ESU.
10! 287! 287! Hey!
Kane back to pass. Forced out of the pocket, running right. Kane on the run, fired! Complete to Griffin at the 10-yard line. Out of bounds, stopping the clock with 7 seconds. A field goal here ties it, but a tie may not get the Wolves into a bowl game. This will be a tough decision for winners.
What do you think? Go for the three?
Just give me the goddamn ball.
Right motion. Tail slant. You're the man, John.
Come on, we're about to win it.
Come on, baby.
Come on.
All right. One time.
Let's go.
All right, everybody. Now's the time. Brown right, motion, tail back slant. Let's put the women and children to bed and go looking for fucking dinner, all right? On one. Ready?
All right. This is the season as the Timberwolves come to the line of scrimmage.
Hey, Dad.
baby.
Yeah, sugar, we did it.
Congratulations.
Thank you.
Daddy, you remember Darnell?
Sure I do. Great catch, Darnell. Great catch.
Thanks a lot. I got something for you. It's my placement test. I got an 89. I believe you got an 87. Ask Coach Winters to look it up for me.
I'll kill him.
Let's get out of here.
Come on, Daddy.
Hey, Coach! Hey, Joe. That was a great throw. Way to hang in there. I'm proud of you.
Thanks for everything. Thanks for everything you did for me.
Next year, the Heisman, huh?
Oh, yeah.
Don't make an idiot out of me, okay?
An amazing conclusion to a great season. We can see Steve Latimer down on the bench, weeping tears of joy as ESU goes back to a bowl for the first time in 3 years.
I know I'm not your favorite person in the world right now, but I need your help with something. All the pressure's starting again, you know? All the Heisman talk, and I feel like I need to go out and blow off some steam, and I was just wondering if you'd go share a six-pack with me.
Tickets are in your bag, player profiles, itinerary, they're in the briefcase. Now, we've got a 9 a.m. tomorrow with that big linebacker from Park High. From there, we go to Atlanta. Need to check out this defensive lineman. He might be our replacement for Latimer next year.